Good morning, everyone. This is Professor N. Swami Gavai, Assistant Professor Group A and Head of Civil Department, Government Engineering College, Raichur. Today, I want to, for the subject, Design of RC Structural Element, I want to discuss you with the module number 4, Limit Shade Design of Slabs and Stairs. In that, the part 1, Slabs. Here in this session, we are going to discuss about what is slab and what is the behavior, what is the geometrical size, and what is the objective of slabs, and how, what is the classification of slab, and what is the method of analysis of slabs, and the general design guidelines for the slabs. See, all these things we are going to discuss in this session. So slab, as its name says, slab is a flat two-dimensional planar structural element having the thickness smaller compared to the two other dimensions. Means the plan dimensions are very large compared to the thickness of the element. It provides a flat surface, a flat working surface, or it provides the covering shelter in the buildings. It is a roof or it is a floor, actually it means. So it primarily transfer the load by bending it one or two directions. See, in the slabs, the behavior of slab is a flexural member. Like a beam, slab is also flexural member. Here, the breadth of the slab is considered as 1 meter, and depth will be lesser than the breadth here. So this is a plate-like element. It is a plate-like element. So the reinforced concrete slabs are used in floors, roofs, and walls of the building as the deck of the bridges. The deck of the bridges also are called slabs. It is a multifunctional and one of the major basic structural component in civil engineering. The floor system of a structure can make many forms, such as in situ solid slabs, ribbed slabs, or precast slabs. Likewise, we can have varieties of slabs. Of course, the varieties, different kind of materials are being under practice. A light material is also used as a superadhesion slab. That is a different thing. We will discuss all those things in the later session. The slab may be supported on monolithic concrete beams, steel beams, or will be rested on the wall directly. And it can be a simply supported, it can be a partially fixed, it can be a completely fixed, or it can be a continuously supported element. So the concrete slab behavior primarily as a flexural member. I already said that it behaves as a flexural member, and the design is similar as that of beams. But here, one thing we need to notice in the design of slabs is slab is designed as singly reinforced or under reinforced section, because the doubly reinforced slabs are under practice. It is not regularly used in the residential or dwellings. Here, the doubly reinforcement is not usually practiced here. But however, the design procedure, design analysis methods are all remain same as similar to the beams. So now we will come to the classification of slabs. How the slabs are classified? That means the classification of a slab based on what? Based on the shape. See, classification of the slab is done with a different methods, means based on the shape. Square slab, rectangular slab, circular slab, polygonal slab. Likewise, based on the shape, geometrical shape, what it is having, that thing we are going to design, we are going to classify. It's a square slab, rectangular slab, likewise, a circular slab, or a polygonal slab, likewise. The based on the type of support, since it is a very, very important thing in a structural designing, the end condition, what we say end condition, or type of support. The slab supported on walls, brick masonry. slab supported on walls, resting on walls like a plane, or slab supported on beams. Slab supported on beams, or another one, slab supported on columns with the help of column heads. Means it is a flat slab. What we say, flat slab, where the beams will not be there, columns and column heads are there. Okay, and the based on the support or boundary condition, simply supported. It is, see, simply the support system and the boundary condition are almost complementary to each other. The wall support can be called as simply supported, and it can also be continuous. A cantilever slab, another one, and overhang slab, fixed or continuous slab. This is based on the support or boundary condition. Based on the use, see, based on the use means whether this slab is going to be used as a shelter alone, then it is going to be called as roof slab. Or if a slab is going to be used as a shelter as well as the floor, then it is called as floor slab. Or it is going to make a supporting thing, or and then it's called as foundation slab. Or whether it is going to use as a water supporting or water tank slab, roof of a water tank or anything else, water tank slab. Based on the sectional configuration, means the section, how, whether it is a only solid slab, means a usually generally commonly what we are seeing, all concrete slabs which are like plate, they are called as solid slabs. Another one, ribbed slab, means a ribbed beams or grid like a beams are supported to form a slab. Or filler slab, means slab is filled with the filler material. Or folded plates, these are all very thin slabs where it has, they are being used in industry. They are like folded plates. The geometrical advantage makes the folded plate to come very with a very thin section, very thin section. They are designed as a plate, folded plate consideration. Based on the spanning, the direction, spanning direction means the spanning in one direction, means the designing, means main reinforcement is arranged in one direction. Means it is one directional spanning, means one way slab. And if the main reinforcement is arranged in both the directions, then it is called as two way slab. Okay, this is all about the based on the spanning directions. Now you can see here the one way slab support here. Here one support is here, another support is here. Here this is called as main reinforcement. You can see main reinforcement will be running in shorter direction. Means it is designed to span in one direction. Means this is susceptible to bend in one direction. Or it is called as single curvature slab. Okay, this is a one dimensional or one way slab. The other direction reinforcement is called as distribution steel. The slabs which are spanning in two direction means the slab bending pattern is there in the shorter span direction as well in the longer span direction also. So if the slab tend to bend in shorter and longer span direction, then this slab to be designed as two-way slabs. Means the reinforcement along shorter span, that is LX, and the reinforcement along longer span LY is to be designed. Here designed as per IS 456 criteria. So this is a double curvature slab, or it is called as a spherical curvature, two curvature spherical slab. So this is two-way slab. Now, method of